Good afternoon, students. Today we will discuss about rocks and its types and uses. So, students, in previous classes we have completed and we understood about the inside of our earth and the layers which are inside in our earth. So, there we discussed about crust, mantle, and core and the different thing about in the crust like oceanic crust and in the continental crust and about what are the minerals is there in the continental crust and in the oceanic crust. So I hope you all understood and you read those topics. So students, in today's class we will discuss about the rocks and its types and its uses. So students, in the rocks we'll discuss about the any natural mass of mineral matter that makes of the earth's crust, that is called a rock. So any natural mass of mineral things that makes the earth's crust is called rock. So the earth's crust is made of different types of rocks. So crust we discussed in the last class. So in the crust, different types of rocks are there. So what are the rocks are there there in the earth's crust? So different rocks like basalt, about granite, all these rocks are there in the earth's crust. So as we understood that in the earth's crust is made of different type of rocks. So any natural mass of mineral substance that makes the earth crust, that is called rock. So students, rocks are different types of rocks are there, and it is divided according to and it's classified according to its color and its size and its texture, its composition. Okay, so what are the three types of rocks are there? Like the first one is the igneous rock, next one is the sedimentary rocks, and after that metamorphic rock. Now you are thinking about that, what is igneous rock? So before I tell you about the igneous rock and about the sedimentary and metamorphic rock, I will tell you the words which igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic originated, from which word these words are originated. So students, the igneous, so this igneous is derived or originated from a Latin word, that is ignis. What is the meaning of that ignis? Fire. So from that word, this from the ignis, which is a Latin word, the meaning of that word is fire. From that word this igneous is derived. Next one is sedimentary rock. So this word is derived from the word sedimentum, from the Latin word sedimentum. What is the meaning of this sedimentum? Settle down. The meaning of the Latin word sedimentum, from where the sedimentary rock word is derived, that is settle down. And the last one is metamorphic. So metamorphic, this is derived from a Greek word. So a Greek word metamorphos. So it is derived from the Greek word metamorphos, which means change of form. So it means change of form. So metamorphic words is derived from a Greek word, and its meaning is a change of form. So students, after we understood from the origin of this word, now we'll discuss more about the types of rocks. So the first rock we discussed about igneous rock. So what is igneous rock? So lava is actually fiery red molten magma coming out from the interior of the earth on its surface. So lava, which is in the liquid rock which is inside of the earth, that comes out from the volcano, which is an opening in the earth crust. From that opening, that molten magma comes out, and we see the lava, the liquid fire we see on the surface of the earth, that we call lava. And the way where that molten magma comes out, the opening where the molten magma comes out from the earth inside of the earth to the surface, that opening is known as the volcano. And the liquid rock which we see on the surface of the earth, that is known as the lava. So I hope you clear about the magma, about the volcano, about the lava. Still, if you have any doubt, you can write that. I will tell you about the definition, which will help you to understand more. So you note down somewhere about the magma and the volcano and about the lava. So what you will write about the magma? Magma is composed of molten rock is stored in the earth's crust. So magma is composed of molten rock, means liquid form of rock, and is stored in the earth's crust. I hope clear. Magma is a molten rock which is stored in the earth's crust. So next is lava. What is lava? Lava is a magma that reaches the surface of our planet through a volcanic opening. Okay. So what is volcano? Again, as I told you that a volcano is an opening in the earth crust through which lava as gases escape. Means that is the remains when the fire completed and the fire totally burned, at that small powders we see there, that also we see along in the lava gases escape from that volcano, right? So next we'll discuss about the igneous rock. So as I told you, in deep of the earth's crust we see different type of magma. Okay, so now we see that, now we'll discuss about what are the, how that comes out to the earth's surface. So you can see from your book also, as it is written there, lava is actually fiery red molten magma coming out from the interior of the earth on surface. When this molten lava comes on the surface, it rapidly cools down and becomes solid. Rocks formed in such a way on the crust are called extrusive igneous rock. Okay, so in the igneous rock, okay, so first, as I told you, what is igneous rock? When the molten magma cools down, it becomes solid. That is known as the igneous rock. So again, I will repeat for you, when the molten magma, when that will cool down, it becomes solid. That is known as the rocks which are formed by this process are called igneous rock. Okay, now I hope you understood about the igneous rock. And igneous rock is called the primary rock, because the other rock which we will discuss later, those rocks are formed by this rock, like sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rock, these are originated and will form from this rock. So as I have told you, igneous rock, when the molten magma cools down, it becomes solid, and rocks which are formed by this process are known as igneous rock. And igneous rocks are two types. One is extrusive igneous rock and another is intrusive igneous rock. So now you are thinking about what is extrusive igneous rock. So students, extrusive igneous rock, so when molten magma comes on the surface of the earth and it rapidly cools down on the surface of the earth, and when it cools down, it becomes solid on the surface of the earth. So rocks form in this process in such a way on the crust are called extrusive igneous rock. So when the molten magma comes out on the surface of the earth and cools down rapidly, and it becomes solid, and after that, in this process, the rocks which are formed, that is known as extrusive igneous rock. And some of the examples of extrusive igneous rocks are basalt. The Deccan Plateau is made of the basalt rock, okay. And when I told you about the basalt, that is a dark colored rock and fine grained rock, dark color fine grained rock. So apart from that, now we'll discuss about after the extrusive. Now we'll discuss about the intrusive igneous rock. Intrusive means the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth's crust. So some of the molten magma, they become cooled down inside the earth's crust, deep inside the earth's crust. So those magma cool down slowly. They form large grains, means small pieces. As in the deep inside of the earth crust, they become solid. So they doesn't cools down very fast. It takes time to cools down. So slowly they cools down. So some grains are formed there. Okay, some grains means small pieces. So granite is an example of that intrusive igneous rock. So grinding stones used to prepare paste, powder or spices, and grains are made of granite. So it was written about that granite is one of the example of intrusive igneous rock. So student, as we have discussed about igneous rock, where I have told you that two types of igneous rocks are there. One is extrusive igneous rock, another is intrusive igneous rock. And the magma which comes out on the earth surface and cools down, that is known as the extrusive igneous rock, like basalt is one of the example. And next, which I have told you, intrusive igneous rocks. When the magma cools down deep inside in the earth crust, it takes time. So slowly it cools down. So some grains are formed. Some grains are formed there. So it is known as the intrusive igneous rock. Like granite, granite is one of the example of intrusive igneous rock. So now you are thinking about some of the examples. What are the different types of igneous rocks are there? So you can note down that, as we have already discussed, like basalt, granite, pumice you can write also. Next you can write these things. As I have told you, these three, gabbro is also there, is one of the example of igneous rock. So granite is used. So granite is very expensive. So granite used for expensive kitchen work and construction of monuments and different types of buildings decoration, granite is used. Then basalt, use of basalt. So when we use basalt and pumice, so pumice is used in the building works as breeze blocks. Pumice is used in the cosmetic and cleaning industry also. Next is basalt. So basalt is used for making of the roads. So when the road construction is when the roads are constructed, this rocks used in the road construction. So students, now we'll discuss about the next, that is sedimentary rocks. So students, as we have discussed about that, sedimentary rocks is derived, sedimentary, that is a word which derived from the Latin word which meaning is sedimentum, and meaning of that is settled down. So next we'll discuss here about sedimentary rocks. Okay. So rocks roll down, cracks and hit each other are broken down in small fragments, small pieces. Fragment means pieces. So rocks roll down and crack and hit each other, and broken down into small pieces. So these small pieces are called sediments. Sediments means small pieces of rocks. These sediments are transported and deposited by wind, water, and air. These loose sediments are compressed and hardened to form layers of the rocks. These types of rocks are called sedimentary rock. So student, when the rocks roll down, when moves and rolling down, and different types of rocks, when they were rolling down, they hit each other, they crack each other, and the cracks are appear on the rocks, and they break into the small pieces. They broke down into small pieces and small fragments, and after they broke down into small pieces, they are known as the sediment. These sediments were carried by the natural forces. When they become very small pieces, then they were carried out by the natural forces like air, water. So when they were carried and deposited and compressed in one place, then it hardened. So next it formed the sedimentary rocks. So like this, sedimentary rocks are formed in this way. So what are the examples of sedimentary rocks? So sandstone is made of grains of sand, and these rocks may also contain fossil of plants, animals, and other microorganisms. So students, when the sedimentary rocks are formed, so sandstone made from grains of sand. So small pieces of sand, they are gathered and compressed, and they harden from harden after they were gathering. After they were gathering, they harden, and some small fossils are there. Small fossils of plants are there. So like this, sedimentary rocks are formed. Sedimentary rocks, sandstone is formed. So when I told you about in the sandstone, fossils are there. What are the fossils? Fossils are the remains of the dead plants and animals trapped inside the layers of rocks. That is known as the fossil. So fossils are the remains of dead plants and animals which are trapped in the layers of rock. That is called the fossils. So students, as we have completed and understood about the sedimentary rocks, now you are thinking about the examples, some of the examples of sedimentary rocks. Like as I have told you, sedimentary rocks, like one is sandstone, and about next you can about write that limestone, and about clay and shale, dolomite. So all these things, sandstone, limestone, mortstone and clay, dolomite. These are the examples of the sedimentary rocks. You can note down this, as this is not mentioned in the book. This will be helpful for you. So student, now we'll discuss about we use the sandstone. So we use the sandstone in different places. Like sandstone are used in different places. It is a building material. When you construct the building, we use this this sandstone for construction of the building. Okay. Next is about the limestone. So student, limestone is used in many different ways, building stone, fertilizer, and glass making industry, cement industry, all these places. So next is about the clay. So clay is also used. Clay is also used in different purposes. Dolomite, as I told you, dolomite and limestone are very similar type of rocks, but they are used in different places, like construction materials. Like construction materials, it is also dolomites are used. So student, after this igneous and sedimentary, now we'll discuss about the last one, metamorphic rock. So when the igneous and metamorphic rock get heat and pressure, they are coming under great heat and pressure, they changes their form and make the metamorphic rock. So when the igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into metamorphic rocks under the great heat and pressure. So what are the sedimentary rocks? They change into metamorphic rock when they get heat and pressure. Like it is mentioned that clay which I told you about, the mudstone, that change into the slate. The clay that change into the slate, and limestone that change into the marble. As I told you that granite is coming under the igneous rock, and when that granite also gets heat and that pressure, that changes into the gneiss, that is coming under the metamorphic rock. So some of the examples of the metamorphic rock are, as I told you, like slate, and about the marble, and next is gneiss, quartzite, soapstone, all these things. So gneiss, so now you are thinking, what is gneiss? Metamorphic gneiss has many uses as building material, such as ornamental stone, and designing of the buildings and wall surface, this gneiss is used. Next is, like we know that marble, it is used as the building, used as a building and sculpture material. Marble can be used in the ground, and used in the source and cleaning products. Slate, we use as the writing board and decorating and the gardening stone. Next is schist also. Schist as also for decoration of gardens. So like student, these are the different types of rocks and its uses. So in next classes, we will read about the uses of rocks. So thank you for attending today's classes. Any doubt you are having, you can ask me in the comment box. I will reply you and clear your doubts. Thank you.